which stands Camp to Have a Gin. this next song is a song from the new record that is in a strange tuning. It's a tuning called Dad Gad. It's a traditional tuning, and a lot of more kind of folk-minded people use it. And one of the people I knew who used this tuning a lot was a guy by the name of Scott Hutchinson, who was from a band called Frank Rabbit, who some of you may know, and if you don't, then I suggest you check them the fuck out. Not now, I mean, finish the gig, Jesus Christ. But Scott was an incredible songwriter, an incredible musician, and an incredible friend. As I'm sure many of you know, in 2018, Scott took his own life, and it was a tragedy, and I miss him every day. And I wrote a song for him for the new record, and I used one of the tunings that he liked, and kind of tried to arrange it like one of his songs. Because as well as being my friend, he was one of my very favorite songwriters ever. I think he was incredible. I actually, this is a story of time. We first met, we were on the same festival circuit together in about 2010, and I was such a huge fan, and he had no idea who I was. And every day for like 2 months we were on the same bill at a festival or an outdoor radio show somewhere in the United States, and we were in a bus and they were in a van, so every day I would find their dressing room and go and sit in it and wait for them to arrive in an attempt to bully them into being my friends. And the rest of the band were like, Jesus Christ, it's the fucking English guy again. But because Scott was a wonderful soul, he made friends with me, possibly out of pity. And we became friends. Anyway, so this is a song for Scott. This song's called The Wave Across the Bay. I spoke with Scott last night. I was tired, but I wasn't sleeping. Despite what you think, I wasn't drinking. I was just finally ready to listen. And he was there, alright. And though he'd probably kill me just for saying this, given how the both of us are atheists, there it is. There must have been a moment just before you hit the water and you were filled with a sense of peace and understanding. With the wind in your hair and the light in your eyes as you realize you were finally escaping. Somehow in that moment you miraculously miss it, like a wave across the bay, never breaking. That's how I like to think of you. Just weeks before you left, we were speaking. I just wish that you had told.